Welcome to Microsoft Virtual Academy. My name is Oğuz Pastırmacı. I'm a technical evangelist working at Microsoft. Today, I'm going to talk about the best practices for maintaining your hybrid cloud. I'm going to show you and talk about profiles, virtual machine templates, and service templates, and how you can use these to accelerate deployments using your virtual machine manager or app controller. But let me talk about our hybrid design first. This hybrid design is the core of Microsoft's Cloud OS vision. As a customer, you benefit from a common and consistent approach to development, management, identity, virtualization, and data, spanning on-premises to cloud. It can be your cloud, a service provider cloud, and Microsoft's cloud, Windows Azure. This is powerful, because we will deliver a flexible development environment for a developer so that it can code once and deploy anywhere. Deploy on premises, deploy out to a partner cloud, or deploy out to Windows Azure. But they only have to write the application once. Unified management is our ability to use System Center sitting in your data center to administer all the automation scripts to manage and pool the resources of that data center. While you are looking in that pane of glass, to be able to provision and move virtual machines, objects, data from your data center out to a service provider or out to Windows Azure for bottomless storage, for redundancy, for disaster recovery. Common identity is a third element of our consistent platform, using Active Directory group policies that you've already set up in your enterprise. You merely get the benefit of those group policies extended through Active Directory Federation services and Windows Azure-based Active Directory, so that the group policies you set extend out to the cloud automatically. You don't have to manage multiple federation common identity across different clouds. Integrated virtualization is the fourth area. Not only are we giving you compute capability with virtualization of your compute capability embedded in Windows Server, we are giving that to you around software-defined networking and around virtualization of storage. Lastly, being able to have a complete data platform where your data can reside anywhere across these three clouds in a seamless way is a value proposition that's huge as well. You can optimize your storage costs in that dimension. All that capability integrated in how we think about the complete data platform for a customer across all clouds. This gives you the ability from a one view to manage apps and data beyond your own private cloud, to a partner cloud, to a public cloud, in a consistent way. It removes complexity so you can focus on answering those business questions and applications. It also helps you to be very flexible in thinking about how you deploy your applications across these three clouds. Windows Azure and Windows Server are at the core of our strategy. So when you think about our Cloud OS, it's not a product. It's the vision and the strategy of how we are framing the overall portfolio of server, cloud, and developer tools so that we bring together Windows Azure, Windows Server, System Center, SQL Server, and Visual Studio into an actual suite. A solution set that our customers benefit from, both from cost savings, from agility and speed, from the ability to transform IT, so you can answer the questions we talked about earlier and address the pressures you're facing around devices, applications, data, and cloud. Now let's take a look at accelerating deployments with templates. In Virtual Machine Manager, it's important to think about templates as the final result of combining a series of layers. The first of these layers is the hardware layer, which contains the relevant virtual machine hardware settings, such as CPU, memory, network, etc., but also a sysprep VHDX file. VMM also handles the sysprepping for you from a gold VM you create prior. Once an admin has defined a specific type of hardware, it can be saved for future use as a hardware profile. This hardware profile can be used with other templates or even just with the regular Create Virtual Machine wizard. What's important to call out, and something that's different to VMware environments, is that a single VHDX file can be used and associated with multiple virtual machine templates, reducing disk consumption from templates. The next one is the operating system config. VMM allows configuration of domain join, admin password, product key, and even the Windows Server roles and features. This configuration can be saved as a guest OS profile, and again, used outside of the template process, or across multiple templates. Application config is what VMM allows admins to add application-level configurations, such as MS Deploy web packages to accelerate deployment of pre-configured websites and applications, server app V packages, which allows admins to create portable, virtualized application images for rapid deployment or migration, or finally, SQL DAG packages, which accelerate SQL Server database deployment. These application-level profiles allow the admin to accelerate the deployment of applications within the VMs, rather than just deploying the VMs on their own. In addition, VMM allows admins to add SQL configuration or deployment files to a virtual machine deployment to accelerate database deployment in the environment. Now let's take a look at how we create profiles and virtual machine templates in VMM. Here I'm on my Virtual Machine Manager 2012 R2. The profiles are on the Library tab. I have several profile options. Let me start with the hardware profiles. As you can see, I have two profiles already created and they are in my library. Let me open the properties of one of it. When I check the hardware profile, I can decide on the physical hardware properties of these virtual machine, such as the number of processors, the amount of memory for this virtual machine, or even if I want this virtual machine to be highly available in case I have a failover cluster installed. Let me show you how you create a hardware profile. Just right-click, create hardware profile. Just asks for a name. Let's say MVA hardware profile. You decide on the generation of the virtual machine, and then you decide on the things like, again, the number of virtual processors, the amount of memory. Let's say you want this virtual machine to start with a gigabyte of memory, and after startup, the minimum memory will be 512 megabytes. When you click OK, a hardware profile with these settings are created. So the first option to use this profile is using the Create Virtual Machine wizard. Normally, when you're creating a virtual machine, VMM first asks you, let me just select a blank virtual hard disk, the name of the virtual machine, let's say MVA01, and in the next step, Virtual Machine Manager asks you to decide on the number of processors, memory, etc. So instead of changing and entering values in these fields every time you create a virtual machine, now you can just select the hardware profile you created before, like the one we created just in this demo, MVA hardware profile. Did you notice that these fields are automatically updated depending on my settings on the hardware profile? Let's check other types of profiles. The second one is called the guest OS profile. Let me create a new guest OS profile. let's say MVA Windows Server 2012 R2 with IIS. In the guest-OS profile, I decide on the operating system of this virtual machine, the name of the virtual machine. If you just select it, if you just leave it like this, it will create a random name, or you can say, hey, just create a virtual machine name starting with MVA, then increment these two digits by one every time I create a new virtual machine. Like the first time it will be MVA01, second time it will be MVA02, and so on. You can set the admin password. For the local administrator account, you can just select the password of the local administrator account, or you can use an account that you already created, which are called run as accounts in Virtual Machine Manager. Let's say you want to use the VMM administrator account to be set as the local administrator account for this virtual machine. You can just select it, and now when the operating system is being installed, the local administrator account will be this account. Next one is the product key. You can insert a product key here so it will ease your activation process. You can decide on the time zone, and this is one of the parts I really like. You can decide on the roles and features for this virtual machine. Remember, I just selected the name Windows Server 2012 R2 with IIS, so I can just say go install the web server role to this virtual machine as a role, and the .NET framework as the feature. So when I'm using this guest-OS profile to create a virtual machine, the operating system, which I selected Windows Server 2012 R2 standard, will be installed with these roles and features. I can also say virtual machine to go ahead and join this virtual machine to a domain. I can just write the details of the domain. Again, I can give virtual machine an account that has privileges to add this virtual machine to a domain, or I can just select a previously created run as account to do this. If you already have an answer file that you're using for your sysprepped disks before, you can also use it just by selecting here. Let me create the guest-OS profile, and it's created here. The next one is the application profile. Application profiles allow me to decide on the properties of the application that will be running on top of this virtual machine. Let me open the properties of the PatchOff app web application profile. You first decide on the compatibility. Will it be a general application, a web application host, or a SQL Server application host? Then you decide on the guest operating system compatibility. So basically, you are saying this web application can be run on top of the operating systems I'm selecting here. And then you decide on like the SQL connection strings or the default name of the default website on IIS, etc. The good thing is your developers can just do this step for you. They can just package this information as a zip file, hand it over to you, and you can just go ahead and browse this zip file to get the settings here automatically. The next one is the SQL Server profile. SQL Server profiles help us to accelerate the deployment of the database tier for our applications. It's very much like the normal, the usual, the common SQL Server installation. You decide on the instance name, the instance ID, the configuration, like do you want TCP IP to be enabled for this SQL Server? Which domain accounts do you want to have access for as SQL Server administrators, the media source to install SQL Server, etc. You can even decide on the server, on the SQL Server service accounts, like the agent service or the SQL Server service. The last two are physical computer profiles. These are the profiles for physical computers. Let's say you have a physical machine, you want to install some operating system on top of it. So you don't have to go ahead and choose everything from scratch. You can just create some physical computer profiles, then apply this to physical machines. And the capability profiles, VMM supports Hyper-V, VMware and Zen Server as the virtualization infrastructure, the virtualization layer. So you can use either of these three infrastructure platforms to put your VMs on top of them. So now I have created my profiles. You see I have several profiles here. As I showed you earlier, you can just use these profiles when you're using the create virtual machine wizard, or even better, you can create virtual machine templates using these profiles you have created earlier. Let me create a virtual machine template. You just select the hard disk for this template. Let's say I want to select the SQL Server VHDX. So this is some SysPrep VHDX. Okay, next, the virtual machine template name. Let's say this is the Pet Shop SQL tier. Next, the hardware profile. I can again go step by step and enter information in all of these fields, but remember, I don't have to do this. I can just select the hardware profile I created earlier. I will just select the hardware SQL profile. Next, I will enter the operating system related settings. Again, I'm just selecting my previously created profile. For the application configuration, I will just select my previously created application profile. And finally, for the SQL Server configuration, I don't have to do anything from scratch. I can just use the profile I already created. So next, create. So my Pet Shop SQL tier virtual machine template is now created and put in my library. When I want to create a virtual machine, when I want to create a virtual machine from a VM template, I can just select the VM templates I already created, like this one. And this template has all the information depending, it depends on the information I entered earlier to the profiles. Now we took a look at the profiles and templates, virtual machine templates in Virtual Machine Manager. We also have a concept called service templates in Virtual Machine Manager. Through service templates, Virtual Machine Manager offers you the ability to define standardized application blueprints. which can be used to automatically deploy application services to shared resource pools, thus simplifying application provisioning. Defining your application requirements with a repeatable construct like service templates makes provisioning faster and less error-prone than when you manually have to deploy the application. Service templates provide the blueprint for the application service, including specifications for the hardware, operating system, and application packages. System-centered 2012 R2 supports multiple package types for .NET applications, including MS Deploy for the web tier and SQL DAC for the data tier. Operationalizing service templates across your service consumer and service provider organizations will likely require active collaboration between the application developers, application operation team, and DC admin roles to discuss and standardize the initial set of hardware, operating system, and application profiles that new applications could adhere to. It might be beneficial to take an incremental approach to testing this capability before rolling out across a broader set of applications. This process will likely require broad sponsorship across the line of business application IT and the infrastructure IT organizations. Once organizationally approved, application blueprints are established and stored in the Virtual Machine Manager Service Template Library, your application owners are ready to deploy applications on their own. They can go to the application owner's self-service experience in System-Centered 2012 R2, called App Controller. They can access and select service templates in App Controller that they have been authorized for. They can easily specify configuration requirements like application topology, scale-out rules, health thresholds, and upgrade rules into the service template, and then kickstart a one-click deployment. Before the application owner hits deploy, App Controller provides a compelling visualization of the holistic application service, including all the requested service tiers and underlying virtual instance templates, storage, compute, and network resources. This enables application owners to think about services and not to think about servers by offering a service-centering approach to provisioning. For managing the service, we leverage the template model, where we can update elements in the template and apply them to the deployed services. The template is the source of truth for the service, and as we make modifications and publish those changes, we can see which services need to be updated. We use the concept of upgrade domains to provide the ability to update the tiers while helping to keep the service available. We have two types of updates, in-place updates and image-based updates. In-place updates means update the application or virtual machine specifications which can be applied to the existing version of the operating system. Update the service without replacing the operating system image. Image-based updates means update to the operating system can be applied by replacing the operating system underneath the application. With this, the process would be to lift up the application, saving the state, replace the operating system, drop the application back onto the updated system, and then restore the state. Let's take a look how in-place updates work. You choose a service template from the library, then deploy an instance of this service you've selected from the library. Then it copies the service template, updates the version number, and updates the application or configuration. Then publish the template and set the deployed service to the new template. And finally, apply the update while maintaining availability of this service through the use of upgrade domains. And now let's take a look at image-based updates. The first step is similar. You choose a service template from the library, you deploy an instance of the service, you copy the service template, update version number, and update virtual disk or application this time. Then publish the template and set the service to the new template. Finally, apply the update while maintaining availability of the service by replacing the virtual hard disk and redeploying the application using upgrade domains. Now let's take a look at service templates in Virtual Machine Manager. I'm again in my Virtual Machine Manager. I go to my library, and now I want to create a service template. The first question it asks is, how many tiers will there be in this service template? I say I am going to have a two-tier application. Let's give it a version, a name. Let's say it will be our pet shop application. Now you see it created me two tiers and connected some network cards, and these two tiers are connected to the pet shop application. So putting a virtual machine to these tiers is easy as just dragging and dropping the templates I created earlier, the virtual machine templates, to the tier. I dragged and dropped the web tier to the tier 1 and the SQL tier to tier 2. So it shows the NICs on top of these VMs. When I choose a tier, it just asks me, how many instances do you want to have? For example, let's say you want to have more than one IIS, more than one web server, and more than one SQL service to keep the high availability of these virtual machines. So you can just say, okay, the default instance count is 1, the maximum instance count is 5, the minimum instance count is 1. And do you want to create an availability set for the tier? Yes. If you check this box, it will try to keep the virtual machines of this tier in different physical hosts to prevent any single point of failure situation. Similar settings are also can be done for the other tier, for the SQL tier. You can say these network interfaces, these network cards, are not connected to any virtual machine networks. So adding a virtual machine network is really easy. I added a virtual machine network. Now I say I want this to be connected to this virtual machine network. Then the next step is to connect these network cards to my virtual machine network. So I choose the connector tool and connect these NICs to my virtual machine network by just dragging and dropping a line between them. So I just connected all of them. Let's say I want to have two web tier machines, or let's say three web tier machines and two database SQL tier machines. I try to save and validate my templates, my service template. And I didn't have any errors. So basically, my service template is now ready to deploy. Let me go to the configure deployment phase. It asks me what will be the name of this service. Let's say it will be my pet shop app service. And it asks me, where do you want to deploy this service? To a cloud or a physical host? I just created a cloud, a private cloud earlier called MVA. So I just selected it. So now my configure deployment screen will show up. Now you see I selected the number of instances for web tier and SQL tier. It says the for SQL tier there will be 2 instances initially, and you can scale up to 5 instances. And for the web tier, it says there will be 4 application tier machines initially, and it will scale up to 5, and the minimum can be 3. So if I'm happy with this configuration, I can just go ahead and deploy the service button, and this service will be deployed in my infrastructure using Virtual Machine Manager. So this is how we create and deploy service templates in Virtual Machine Manager. Now let's take a look at how we manage application across multiple clouds. This is a conversation that comes up a lot where our customers have some on-premise application and maybe they are looking at Windows Azure applications and they need to understand how we do it. We have the two constructs here. We have private cloud on the left hand side, which is a virtual machine manager cloud, and we have multiple hypervisors. We support Hyper-V, VMware, and Zen Server. And then we have a service template model that sits on top of that to deliver our applications. Now on the right hand side, we have Windows Azure or a service provider cloud, which has a package and configuration model. And what we want to be able to do is deploy, monitor, and manage your applications regardless of where they are running. This we can do with App Controller. Now App Controller enables us to manage both on the left-hand side a virtual machine manager service and also on the right-hand side either Windows Azure application from within a single console or an application on a service provider. We can see information on what's running, we can see how many instances are running, and so forth. And we can also go through and perform actions against these services, as well as deploying new applications on both the private clouds and public clouds. System Center 2012 R2 App Controller offers a unified management view across clouds. It empowers application owners with a self-service application management experience across on-premises, service provider, and Windows Azure clouds. It puts your IT pros firmly in control with visibility and control across on-premises, service provider, and Windows Azure resources and applications. It enables you to easily manage services through a highly intuitive service-centric interface. Additionally, organizations that need application portability to free up on-premises data center capacity, for example, can use App Controller to move virtual machines to the Windows Azure Virtual Machine Service. They can migrate core applications such as Microsoft SQL Server, Microsoft's Active Directory, and SharePoint Server from on-premises environments to Windows Azure with just a few mouse clicks. Now let's take a look at the overview of App Controller. This is my overview screen in App Controller. As you can see, you access App Controller using a web browser. The overview screen shows the clouds I have to manage. For example, I have my private cloud, my virtual machine manager server, and also I configured my Windows Azure subscription. I added my Windows Azure subscription to manage it using App Controller. Let's take a look at clouds. It shows that I can manage my NVMe private clouds on my SCVMM01 Virtual Machine Manager server and also my Windows Azure subscription. When I click on Virtual Machines, it shows me all the virtual machines in both of these two clouds. As you can see, I don't have any virtual machines in Windows Azure yet, and I have several virtual machines in my private cloud infrastructure. I also have access to my library in Virtual Machine Manager and also my storage account and images in Windows Azure subscription. So let's say I want to create a virtual machine in Windows Azure. How do I do it? There are several ways, but I can just go to Virtual Machines, hit Deploy, select Windows Azure as the cloud, select the deployment type. So I can use an image in my container if I have any. For example, I may have uploaded a virtual machine disk, or I can also use the image library of Windows Azure. So I can just go ahead and select Windows Server 2012 R2. I then have to configure the cloud service. I already created one. If you want to create a new cloud service, you can just create a new one using the app controller as well. Next, it asks me the name of the new deployment. Let's say this will be my NVA web application. I can choose if this is a staging or production environment. For this is a single tier environment, I cannot select staging. And I don't have any virtual networks configured in Windows Azure, so that nothing shows up in the list. Click OK. Then I configure the properties of the virtual machine. The name of the virtual machine, let's say VM 05 Windows Azure. Or just say Windows Azure. Then I decide on the instance size. These are the sizes that are available on Windows Azure at the moment. Let's say I want to have a medium size virtual machine. Then I choose the container. Container account here. Okay. So my disks of this virtual machine, the disks of this virtual machine will be placed in these containers. I can set the network or anything I do when I'm creating a virtual machine using Windows Azure portal. And the last part is to enter a username and password. When I hit on deploy, App controller will go connect to my Windows Azure subscription and then create a virtual machine depending on the properties I have selected. After a while, I will see that something is happening in my cloud service. In the meantime, let me deploy a virtual machine in my private cloud. Same thing. The same way I should follow, but now I choose my NVA private cloud as my target cloud. I can use the templates I created. Remember, I created a pet shop app service. I can also use services, and I created the NVA virtual machine template. So I can just choose the template and configure the virtual machine, the name of the virtual machine, for example, VM04 private cloud. These fields are auto-populated depending on the template properties. So OK. When I hit on deploy, now App Controller also is going to connect to my virtual machine manager server and create a new virtual machine in my private cloud called MVA Private Cloud. Let's check if Windows Azure is... See, my virtual machine on Windows Azure is being created, and I didn't I wasn't logged in, I didn't have to go to the Windows Azure portal and create the virtual machine here. Instead, I used App Controller to manage my clouds. This could be a private cloud, a virtual machine manager server, a public cloud like Windows Azure, or if you are using a hosting service provider's cloud, you can also add this subscription here and manage it using App Controller. You can also create user roles in App Controller. So you can just say, I want to add some members, some Active Directory accounts to this role, and the person who is a part of this role will only be able to start virtual machines. This person will only be able to create a new virtual machine from a template only, not from scratch. So we the role-based access is really helping us to provide our users with a self-service portal by using App Controller. Let's check the virtual machines. The VM01 private cloud virtual machine is created, and the Windows Azure one, VM05 Windows Azure, is currently being provisioned. So that sums up our recording. For some additional content, for some additional content about hybrid cloud, I recommend you to go to TechNet Evaluation Center and download the evaluation products for Windows Server 2012 R2 and System Center 2012 R2. You can use both of them for up to 6 months, 180 days. And the second option, I really recommend you to go to TechNet Virtual Labs. These are completely free, hands-on, deep technical labs, and you just access these technical lab environment by using only your web browser. You don't have to download an ISO or install anything. You just go use your browser and go to join this virtual lab environment. And last but not least, Microsoft Virtual Academy has many free online technical courses. You can just choose the course you like and start doing it on your own pace. Thank you very much for listening, and see you next time.